video is going to be on weld discontinuities and defects. On the board, I've written all of the discontinuity and defect key terms. This is something that we're going to go over throughout the remainder of the classes. Something that I'm going to go through as well. So some of this I'm just going to be reading from the book, and then others I'm just going to be talking to you about this. But throughout the class, we are going to learn about the weld discontinuities and defects key terms. So throughout this class, you will be learning about discontinuities and defects and why they are caused and how to fix them. You probably have already heard me talk about discontinuities and defects in previous classes because that's how projects are graded, based on if there were any imperfections. If a project is flawed and has imperfections, you should want to know why it happened and what caused it and figure out a way to fix it. Whether it's porosity or lack of fusion, you should want to fix it and find a way for it to not happen again. This is all a learning process until one day it just comes to you as second nature. So, with that being said, we're going to cover what discontinuity, defect, and flaws are and their definitions. The term discontinuity refers to anything that is not exactly like its surroundings, in short, a lack of uniformity. The term defect refers to any discontinuity that is so large or in such a location that it would cause the part not to meet the applicable standard. A flaw is another word used to describe a discontinuity in welds. All welds have discontinuities and flaws, but they are not necessarily defects. So as you see, there are a lot of different discontinuities and defects. This is all going off of codes and standards, depending on what can be passed through and what will get rejected. So this is going off of a definition through the American Welding Society, or AWS. They define as a discontinuity or discontinuities that by nature or cumulative effect render a part or product unable to meet minimum applicable acceptance standards or specification. This term designates rejectability. Examples of defects are total porosity or length of slag inclusions. Ideally, a weld should not have any discontinuities, but that is practically impossible. So most piping systems have welds that contain some discontinuities, and that is fine so long as these discontinuities fall within acceptable limits. The acceptable limits for discontinuities are determined by the code or standard that is being used. The code or standard is based on what type of weld would be fit for service, meaning that there is a very high likelihood that the weld will never fail during the expected life of a piping system. So the only difference between a discontinuity and a defect is when the discontinuity becomes so large or when there are so many small discontinuities that the weld is not acceptable under the standards for the code for that product. Some codes are more strict than others, so that the same weld might be acceptable under one code but not another. But some piping systems cannot have welds that contain defects because the system is no stronger than its weakest weld. The 9 most common discontinuities for pipe welds are porosity, inclusions, inadequate joint penetration, incomplete fusion, arc strikes, overlap or collap, undercut, crater cracks, or underfill. So in relation to this, we're going to jump to the summary of this whole video. It's important to try and make every weld as perfect as possible. Watching the molten weld pool carefully, understanding the stresses a weld has on the joint, and skillfully setting up and performing the weld will help you make the best weld possible. Welding is often referred to as being more of an art than a science, but in reality, it is both. Laying a weld bead on a pipe joint takes as much skill as when an artist makes a brushstroke on a canvas. But you must also understand the underlying physics and chemistry of a weld too. Becoming a highly skilled welder is a lifelong learning exercise. You should learn something from each weld and welding job. After each weld, take note of the results and what factors contributed to them. For example, how did that undercut happen? Or why did that crack form? But most important, watch other welders and learn from them as well. Someday, every weld you make will be discontinuity free. So this is just covering, you know, the defects and discontinuities. We are going to cover each of these key terms, and we're going to go more in depth into that. But this was just a quick video to go over that right now. If you have any questions or concerns about this video, please just let me know. Thanks.